Hey guys, I'm Ashley and this is Elsa, and today we are going to be making some Animal Crossing 3D printed keychains in dual colors with a single printer. So let's check it out here on Chip Builds.
Your attention, please. The Nookie getaway package charter flight will soon be arriving at the deserted island.
Okay, so I already drew these symbols in Illustrator beforehand. I knew they were going to be keychains, and so I just made them the proper size. They're roughly about an inch, and the little circles for the keyrings are about 2 millimeters. So what we want to do is create this border around our symbols that we've drawn. And what you'll do is you'll come over here to Object and you'll go to Path, and then you'll click Offset Path. And then you can have it be however big or small you want. I think I ended up going back in and changing it to 10 points, and then that gives us a nice little outline. And then now we have them all matching for each one. And then now what we can do is, you know, we can make sure everything's how we want it, and then we can export this as a DXF file, because that's what we want to bring into Illustrator to extrude these shapes. So, and then we want to come up here and make sure it's set to 1 inch. So switch that to 1. 1 inch equals 1 unit, because that's what Fusion 360 likes. So now we can hop into Fusion 360, and the first thing I always do is save my document, that way it's in the correct place. And I just won't have any issues, because I have been times in the past where I made a whole project and I forgot to save it and then I lost it all. So we'll come over here to insert, we'll choose whatever plane, we'll choose the DXF file that we had just made, and the Animal Crossing, and bring it in here. And then it kind of takes Fusion a second to get that in there because we have a lot of complex shapes in here. So now we can see we have our sketch with all the different symbols, and we can bring this in to our plane, and I like to just center it on the origin. Just personal preference, you can do whatever you want. I got a warning for the little money bag. I wasn't quite sure what happened. I ended up just saving the document, exiting after I'd done all of the symbols, and then it let me do it, so I really don't know what was going on. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use E for extrude, and we're gonna extrude all these top shapes. And then now our sketch went away, but we'll just go over here to the sketch panel, turn it back on, and now we can extrude all the outlines for these keychains. We don't have to worry about the hole for the keychain hardware, because if we just leave it, it'll end up being an empty hole. Okay, so now we'll hit E for extrude again, and this time we're going to do all the different outlines. Next we're going to hit E again for extrude, and we're going to select all the outlines of these keychains, and we are going to make these 2 millimeters thick. So I made the base of these keychains 2 millimeters thick, that way I knew where I needed to cut the filament going through the printer so that I could swap colors. Now there's a bunch of different ways you can do this. The easiest way would probably be to use Prusa Slicer, because you can, you know, set a point of where it will stop and raise the nozzle and stuff, but I didn't want to deal with all of that, so I just did a really quick and dirty, you just chop the filament off and put the new color in. So now we have our extruded keychains, and then we're going to save them all out as STLs, and then we are going to print them. So I printed all of these on my Anycubic i3 Mega S. I got this on sale during Chinese New Year, and it's a great little printer. But for whatever reason, I was really struggling doing these keychains on this printer. I think it was a mix of my bed not being leveled, and I was just having some issues with the filament not fusing to each other on a couple of them. So the quick way to do a filament swap is on this one. It has a filament runout sensor, so at a specific point I'll just chop it and then I'll pull it out of the sensor, and then the machine will stop and it'll ask me to load a new filament, and then that's how I get that second color. So when I went to print the leaves, it printed out perfect and I was so happy, and I knew this project was going to be really awesome looking. And then I went to print these little gyroid keychains, and that just wasn't going to happen. Well guys, this was a really fun project to do. As I said, I'll have all the files linked down below for this project. They're a lot of fun to make, and Elsa decided she wanted to be in the outro and intro of this video. So I did have some issues, like I said, with the two different PLA materials bonding, so if you have any suggestions on how to fix that, or just if you know exactly why that happened, let me know in the comments down below. That'd be greatly appreciated. If you like this video, please consider sharing it or just giving it a thumbs up, and please subscribe to my channel. I do try to put out some interesting projects every month, and that would help a lot. So thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.